asking questions.
So I'm talking to you?
I was shocked.
That's a big question.
Ooh, all right. Yeah, that's a tough one.
I will talk to you.
You didn't ask me the one question, which was the valid question.
Right, right. I'm not trying to sugarcoat. I'm trying to think how I want to word it.
It's way more raw. It's way more intense. It's way more personal.
There's a lot of buzz out there right now. And I think with the push, nothing can't be done.
You know, the more that we get those stories out, the more that we see the people that are involved and the things that they go through, I think that that's probably going to be the thing that gets them.
You get two shows out for the price of one, essentially.
It's all competition in its purest form.
I have respect for anyone doing any sport.
Hey, live your dream. Have fun. Do what you do. How can I help you do what you do?
The distance they used to ride in York was a bit wimpish, you know. Everything's the fairer sex can't ride like the men.
You see that the women are much way tougher than the men. They don't like it if I say this to these men.
They were crazy. There's some weird, strange
I can imagine.
There.
It's a good job Bob wasn't there because he would have been, hello, mummy.
What I do notice in America is the fields are huge. There's a lot of women who want to ride the bikes and race well here.
Really, it's just about racing. Getting more races, bigger races, and I think that'll bring more focus to the women's peloton.
There's a lot of razzmatazz attached to women's racing, and it's now become very, very professional.
And women and men are a little bit different. Men will do about 80% of what you say, and women will do 100% of what you say.
There's no horse barred, they're not, you know, soft pedaling it, it's racing out there.
They still do the 5-hour training rides, they still race in the rain, they still, you know, suffer and hurt themselves.
You know, there are a lot of great stories in women's cycling, there are a lot of great stories with the people who are in it, the races that are happening, and, you know, what might get press and attention within a race report in a men's race, it happens just the same as it does in women's races.
They pretty much get to do all the big races that the men do. The unfortunate side of things is they don't get the press coverage as much as the men do.
I think women's cycling is just as exciting as men's cycling, if not more exciting. They're beautiful.
The women in our domestic peloton and on the world stage are out there suffering just as hard as anyone else in the world, and it's a beautiful, beautiful thing to see.
Well, I mean, they really put together a visually great-looking team. Besides, it checks your heart.
By Kristen Armstrong, which is, I mean, it's a blessing actually for all of us because she has so much experience and she's so confident and she's taken the sport to the highest level. And people know her name in women's sports, not just cycling. People in other sports know Kristen Armstrong.
You know, for me, I'm just really excited to give back and share my knowledge with these girls and help them learn to become the best.
Women's cycling
is still part of cycling. And cycling is a whole sport. It goes all around. And with men's cycling, you have these huge venues without women's racing. So where's all the women's racing, and why isn't the prize money equal?
The riders do get motivated by things other than a paycheck. And the riders do get motivated by things being in place for them in a way that they feel like it's a bit more of a family atmosphere and the team actually cares for them.
Those guys run pretty fast. And when I say guys, I mean girls.
If you see the women, they crash, they have a big hole in the knee, and you just stand up and say, yeah, okay, I'm here, I have a hole, no problem.
It's girls are now beating guys that need to be a little faster. So watch out, boys. Girls are doing the homework, and they're going to whoop you.
We did an uphill time trial, and I think like the lady that won the time trial did like better than two or three of my guys, so we give our guys a bit of hell about that.
The growth was perfect. It wasn't like there was just one huge splash where they said, we're going to rule the world of women's bike racing.
Well, what impresses me about the Peanut Butter Girls is how real they are.
You've got Olympic medals, world championships. Just any race they go to, they're in it to win.
So Peanut Butter and Company 2012 is really setting new standards in the women's pro peloton this year. They're racing a lot like a men's professional team, top level.
We saw them recently at Gila in Silver City, New Mexico, and they raced the race like a men's team. They controlled it from the front to the end, and that's something you don't see very often in women's bike racing.
They're really one of the top American programs. They bring a lot of energy, excitement, and constantly improving results and athletes.
We vicariously live our dreams through teams like Peanut Butter and Company.
It's nice to finally, after so many months, finally catch up to a jar.
You know, everybody likes peanut butter, and everybody likes the monkey. You know, the monkey on the car, you know, people get excited about that. So
the frog and the monkey, they kind of work together, you know.
American legends in cycling on the female side are just now being built. So I think it's nothing but pure opportunity.
Women's bike racing is one of the most exciting sports in the world, and if you don't tune in, you're missing out.
That's why I do what I do. I mean, I love bike racing.
Everybody's out here to win and to race and to, you know, have fun. And it's like, it's not just kind of recreational. It's like everybody's passionate, and it's something that inspires me, and it's being a part of that.